Hello, everyone, and welcome to episode 110 of Unknown Empire SMP. This episode, I have returned to the Volitare library because, despite the fact that the attack on Vinctum is imminent, there is some further knowledge that I wish to acquire from this place before heading off there. So I'm just going to casually pass these library sentries outside and retrieve the key card. I know that I hid this thing back last time when I discovered it, but it's actually been found by other people and placed on the desk right here. So I'll just pop it off, place it in the barrel, and watch the door open. Yep, there we go. So, oh, there's a creeper. So, what I noticed while reading up on General Vlad and the Regions of Illa last time was that there was an enchantment table down here while I was hiding from the various mobs. And I figured, what if that book has some other meaning to it other than just, you know, allowing me to enchant all of these tools and armor and stuff. So, I thought about investigating it a little bit and seeing if there was something else that I could gather from this book, because it seems very magical, you know? I mean, the pages turn, you can perhaps read out of it other than just, you know, using its power to enchant tools. So, I figured I would try and look up a timeline of the Unknown Empire's history to get a better understanding of all of the historical events that have happened in Ibrinon and beyond. Okay, guys, I have found the timeline. So, I'm going to read it out from this book, and you'll have a special overlay appear in front of you so that you guys can see what's written in here as well. So, the timeline is organized in 2 years based on the creation of the Seven Flames, which are these tools and weapons and stuff that were created a couple hundred years ago for a distant war. And we've explored a little bit of this in a previous episode. I believe it was episode 61 where we located one of these seven tools. It was a compass. Yeah, this is what the years are based around. So it's before the Seven Flames, or BSF, and after the Seven Flames, or ASF. So, without further ado, I will read you all the timeline of the Unknown Empire. 5,000 BSF, Tatros, Zovan, and Atristan are created. 4,500 BSF, the first humans appear in Ezton and Delgan, while the first testificates, or villagers, appear in Viburnum. 1320 BSF, the Illa United Pact is formed, consisting of five nations, Viridi, Silva, Manassas, Viburnum, and Ignis. And also, Viridi annexes Vetula. In 1285, Tesca is discovered by Sylvan explorers and joins Illa. 1250, the Viridi-Isola War begins. In 1240, the Battle of Malone occurs, followed by the Viridi-Isola War ending, freeing Isola and Batur from Viridian rule in 1239. Now, in 555 BSF, Lord Skulton is born. Skulton's father, the current Nyshan ruler, declares the first Darcrim War against the Piglins. 539, Skulton inherits the throne from his father, who was assassinated by the Piglins. Skulton becomes the youngest Nyshan ruler in history as a result. Skulton also utilizes the Soul Reapers in battle, turning the tide of the war back in the Nyshan's favor. In 537 BSF, the Nyshans establish their dominance over Darcrim by winning the first Darcrim War. And in 525 BSF, Skulton's son, Skulton II, is born. In 511 BSF, paranoid of an attempt on his life that would mirror his father's assassination, Skulton wages the Second Darkroom War by attacking Piglin settlements with the Soul Reapers. In 500 BSF, Skulton II has a daughter named Lady Bellum. Skulton II also establishes the first nether portals on Darcrim. Skulton hands the throne to his son, Skulton II, aka Spooky Skulton, in 496, as he seeks out new methods of eradicating the Piglins. Skulton II also has a son named Lord Decimere. In 493, Skulton creates the Skult Stars, unleashing the Withered Beast upon the Piglins. Skulton II slays Skulton's wither, his face permanently scarred, forcing him to mask his deformities. Skulton II exiles his father, as a result, to Ibrinon for war crimes. 492, Skulton II hands the throne to his daughter, Lady Bellum, unable to lead the empire due to being crippled by the wither. Lord Decimer then begins developing the Decimators at the request of Lady Bellum. Skulton and the Soul Reapers also begin constructing the Skult Temples in Ezhtin. In 485, Skulton dies during the construction of his larger temple buried by the Soul Reapers in the Skult Temple's catacombs. The Soul Reapers then die off in the years following. In 482 BSF, impatient with Decimer's progress on the Decimator cannons, Lady Bellum travels to Ezhtin in search of the Skult Stars, amassing an army of Withers to finally end the war. The Withers then lose control as a result, destroying both the Nyshan and Piglin forces, killing Lady Bellum and Skulton II in battle. Lord Decimer then inherits the throne and completes the first Decimator cannons, eradicating the Withers. The Second Darcrim War finally comes to an end as the Piglin rebellions are quelled by the threat of facing the Decimators. Then we skip a few centuries and enter 1 BSF, where the Altria-Rakhaim War begins. And in 0 BSF, this is where the Seven Flames are created and used in the Altria-Rakhaim War. And also, Vlad the Eternal, aka General Vlad, is born at this time. Now in 1 ASF, 1 year after the creation of the Seven Flames, after nearly wiping each other out, Altria and Rakhaim end their war. 59 years after the creation of the Seven Flames, Vlad develops the first Totem of Undying. The Evokers begin using the totems as defense mechanisms, but Vlad goes into hiding with a handful of eager students to perfect their dark magic. In 116 ASF, one of Vlad's students discovers the Resurrection Star and its shrine, accidentally reviving Ezhtin's deceased population. Palumber then undergoes a zombie siege, taking the lives of Jack and the Sentry Wolf, later known as Tombstone. And Jack is one of the villagers that inhabited Polartica. He was one of the first allies that I had last season. Then in 120 ASF, humans discover Illa and befriend the villagers. The zombie plague makes its way overseas, infecting several inhabitants of Illa and other regions. In 127, the villagers seek the help of the Illagers in order to combat the undead, learning how to use magic in the process. In 141, Ivan the Illusioner is born. In 148, Lord Darkon, the current Nyshan leader, is born. And in 150, the Unknown Quest takes place, which is a whole different story that has yet to be published. In 171, General Pumpig and Commander Piglow establish a Piglin rebellion against the Nyshans. Lord Darkon then retaliates with the use of upgraded Decimator cannons, waging the third and final Darkrim War, as of now. In 173, the humans discover Illager settlements. Tatros also has King Alfred order the decimation of the Illagers after their refusal to become trading partners. Totems of Undying are also distributed throughout Ibrinon as a result of Tatros' invasion. The villagers then refuse to aid the Illagers in their recovery, sparking the Illagers' resentment of their counterparts. In 177, the assassin known as the Crimson Shadow is born. In 180, King Emmerich takes the throne of Tatros after King Alfred's death. Then Lord Darkon uses the Skult Stars to revive dead Nyshan warriors, including Skulton, his son Spooky Skulton, Lady Bellum, and Lord Decimer. In 181, the followers of Tatros and Atristan clash, with Tatros emerging victorious. The remaining Atristan worshippers take refuge in Castan, aka the Kingdom of the Skult. As a result, King Emmerich also marries Queen Livia, and meanwhile, on Darkrim, a Nyshan infant later known as Darkblade was born. In 182, King Emmerich's daughter, Princess Rhea, is born. Also, Captain Dusk, a future Nyshan sergeant, is born. The infant Darkblade is then kidnapped by Jimbo, a Piglin pillager, during an attack on a rural Nyshan village on Darkrim. Darkblade is then abandoned near a Nyshan nether fortress, cared for by the undead soldiers. In 185, Vlad returns from his self-exile, leading a small group of resentful Illagers that attack villager settlements in South Viridi. In 186, General Radicus and his Killagers retaliate against Vlad by attacking Illager settlements. There's also something blocked out here. I wonder if there's some sort of sensitive information here that someone, maybe Ivan or Vlad or some other magical being, could have somehow blocked out from this book. But we'll just skip past that. I'm sure we'll find out eventually. In 187, Ivan helps Vlad gather an army of Illagers to rebuild their empire and eradicate the Villagers, sparking the Villager-Illager War. Ivan and Vlad's influence then causes Viridi to divide into North Viridi and South Viridi. In 191, with the combined forces of the Decimator Cannons as well as the soldiers of the past and present, the Nyshans are able to win the Third Darcrim War after Skulltin zombifies Pumpig and Piglo and escapes into the Nether. The Piglins are subsequently exiled into the Nether, terraforming the available land into new crimson forests to resemble their home. The Decimator Cannons leave a lasting effect on the Nether terrain, creating the basalt deltas. Lord Darkon also banishes the undead Nyshans into the Nether, causing them to abandon Darkblade. The following year, Darkblade meets his buddy Cubert the Magma Cube, his first and only friend at the time. Then in 193, Skulltin discovers Darkblade and his advanced melee skills, taking the boy in and manipulating his anger. Darkblade, Skulltin, and Cubert then reach Esten and establish Polartica, and then they encounter a zombified villager child named George, which Darkblade vows to take care of. Darkblade also takes in several other misfit monsters, keeping them in Polartica. The following year, Darkblade and Skulltin discover dezombification in order to revive George, Jack, and many other zombified villagers. In 195, Skulltin then takes Darkblade to the Skult Temple, establishing the Skult. Darkblade also explores the Palumbran Tomb, meeting and naming Tombstone. In 196, Darkblade takes in villager refugees fleeing Illa, later exploring North Viridi in search of resources. Lord Darkon also orders the execution of all remaining Piglin refugees, assigning the Crimson Shadow to locate their bases. Two Piglins, Arius and Brutus, colonize an island in Ignis to escape the Nyshans, establishing the town of Arum. That must be what that book in the Bastion was referring to. Then in 197, Princess Rhea is banished from Tatros for supporting the god Atristan, while Darkblade takes in a zombified General Pumpig as well as his undead allies. Darkblade also goes on another expedition with his new wolf Scout and the Skult Hounds. Unfortunately, only he and Scout survive. In 198, several groups of travelers discover and settle in Esten. Tatros places Esten in a pocket dimension, temporarily removing it from Ibrinon. Meanwhile, the saviors of the waking world and the Mincino clan establish Reverie and Madeira, respectively. Reverie then allies itself with Tatros. Now this is where we enter real time. This is when the Unknown Empire story officially starts. At this point, I oversee the construction of Wellspire in 199 ASF. So this is where the official beginning of my time in Season 2 starts, even though it's already been mentioned that some of the other things I've done have happened before that. But, you know, it's all different in the canonized timeline. So, following that, Darkblade introduces Skulltin to Toby and Forge, who then join the Skult after a trial prank on Reverie. Skulltin sends Darkblade to Tatros, knowing they won't accept him, feeding his anger. As a result, Darkblade kills a Tatros guard, followed by losing a duel with Lucius, the head guard of Tatros. Skulltin eagerly watches Darkblade, Toby, and Forge take control of Kastan as retaliation, renaming it as the Kingdom of the Skult and starting a war. The saviors make a failed effort to return the kingdom to Tatros that results in Toby's demise, fueling Darkblade's resentment of humans. Darkblade blames Tatros for ransacking his kingdom and attacks theirs, discovering the supernatural powers of a local child named Jimmy. During the Battle of Tatros, the saviors invade the Lost Kingdom, which kills Forge. Darkblade inherits the kingdom, letting King Nitty Witty rule it locally. Darkblade, General Pumpig, and Emperor Polaris then establish the Palumbran Empire with these new territories, and Darkblade ends the Skult-Tatros War in order to protect the citizens of his empire, while simultaneously gaining the opportunity to spy on Tatros' affairs from within his territories. Venomora and the Kingdom of the Skult are also handed back to Tatros for the time being. Darkblade will later meet Princess Rhea in the Kingdom of the Skuld, shortly after investigating Tatras' Endermite research study. Claude is then recruited into the Skuld in a quest to reclaim Darkblade's lost equipment from Tatras, as well as quelling a prison riot in the Skuld Temple orchestrated by Agatha the Witch and Deadeye the Zombie Villager. Tatras also orders Lucius to execute Jimmy in order to maintain his power. Rhea then reveals her identity to Darkblade, Claude, and Xayrlayer, and now we transition into 200 years after the creation of the Seven Flames. So, at this point, Darkblade reluctantly joins Rhea and a group of familiar human travelers in discovering King Emmerich's secret study. Shortly after Tatras' malicious nature is realized, Atristan refugees are discovered in the Rigugi camp. Meanwhile, in Illanaut, Ivan the Illusioner orders Captain Cross to attack the village of Securus in the Betur region, resulting in its destruction. The Skuld and the Palumbran Empire join the Saviors, Atristan worshippers, and the Mancino clan in mounting an attack on the Forbidden Kingdom, now heavily guarded by Tatras sentries. The endgame then takes place, resulting in the salvation of Tatras' citizens, rescue of Zovan and Atristan, and imprisonment of Tatras himself. The end was also discovered, where Claude met his demise at the hands of Tatras' dragon. Darkblade reclaims the Kingdom of the Skuld and Venomora, as well as the Forbidden Kingdom. The death of the first Ender Dragon, however, causes a dimensional disturbance, creating nether portals throughout Ibrinon and Darcrim that allow the Piglins to escape Lord Darkon's wrath. The Nyshans quickly work to dismantle the portals, and this, my friends, is how we get the ruined portals across the world. Meanwhile, Darkblade ransacks an Illager mansion and outpost in North Viridi while searching for totems of undying in order to defend his empire. Also, the alliance with the Keepers of the Crystal is made. The Crimson Shadow is also separated from his squadron of stealth troopers, also known as the Skuld Warriors, during a battle with Commander Piglow. Upon realizing the deaths of half of his soldiers, Ivan sends Captain Cross to Ezton to bring Darkblade to justice. Meanwhile, the Skuld Warriors, led by Captain Scar and Sergeant Dusk, wind up in Ezton and join forces with the Skuld because, you know, Nyshans. Skulton also sends Darkblade to reacquire the Skuld Stars, hoping that the Wither and Ender Dragon combined will be enough to kill Darkblade so Skulton can take over the Palumbran Empire. However, being the badass Nyshan warrior that I am, Darkblade survives the encounter, puts Skulton on probation, guarded by the Nyshan Skuld Warriors, and naming Captain Scar the new Skuld leader. During Darkblade's clash of bosses, however, the Crimson Shadow tracks down and executes Commander Piglow. The death of the second Ender Dragon causes another dimensional disturbance, though, this time corrupting Darkrim's Crimson Forests into warped blue variants filled with Ender energy due to their connection with the Nether Portals. Captain Cross then leads the 81st Battalion into the Battle of Venomora, which Darkblade and several human travelers defeat the Illagers, with Cross escaping into Ezton's Mesa region. And during this battle, the Crimson Shadow travels throughout Ezton in search of answers for the disturbances, learning of Darkblade's treachery. Sergeant Dusk, who has realized the error of the Nyshan's ways, reports his presence to Darkblade. Ivan then sends Captain Sullen to Ezton after Cross's failure, while Darkblade hunts down Cross, while Crimson Shadow investigates Tatras and the Forbidden Kingdom. Crimson then encounters the lone survivor of a crashed Illager scouting ship sent to recover the 81st, which would be Vincent. Darkblade and Sergeant Dusk hunt down Crimson and Vincent on Vacuo, soon capturing them near New Apoloth. Then Vincent and Cross are sent to the Palarctic prison while Crimson is used as a test subject, resulting in the creation and subsequent escape of the Warped Shadow. The Crimson Shadow escapes on a boat intended for Rakhaim, crash landing in Viburnum instead? The Warped Shadow escapes into Ezton's vast cave network. Oh, so that's where he went. Captain Sullen takes control of Traveler's Landing, naming himself Mayor. Yeah, been there, done that. Darkblade hunts him down, kills Sullen's scouts in Vacuo with help from Zovan. I knew it! I knew she had something to do with that. Those Illagers were acting weird that day. But then Mayor Sullen sends the 84th Battalion to attack the Lost Kingdom and the Kingdom of the Skuld. Darkblade manages to defeat the Illagers and capture Sullen, Scourge, Dire, Doom, and Gloom. Meanwhile, Captain Scar, and several citizens of the Lost Kingdom were killed in the conflict. Dusk then takes Scar's place as captain. Lucius also leaves Tatros to help relocate the Rigugi refugees. Tatros citizens, upset with Emmerich's weakness and former blind loyalty to the manipulative god, stage a coup and successfully remove Emmerich from power due to Lucius's absence. Their leader Charles takes the throne. So that's what's been going on in Esten this whole time. Alright, Darkblade returns the Skult Stars to the Devil's Worship. Wait, that happened before that? After intentionally leaving an illager named Bill free at Camp Cross, Darkblade learns of Ivan's leadership role and heads to Illa, leaving Captain Dusk to keep the Skult and Palumbran Empire in balance. Well, hopefully he can deal with this whole Tatros insurrection, but I guess we'll have to see about that. Anyway, we are now entering the current year, which is 201 ASF. While Darkblade is on his way to Illa, Esten falls into disarray, starting with a group of piglins taking over Vacuo. Wait, what? Piglins in Vacuo? Maybe it has to do with the amount of smoke and sulfur and just volcanic air in there? I mean, they seem to be able to survive in the Nether, so maybe if they stay close to the lava in Vacuo, then it allows them to survive? I don't know, but hopefully Captain Dusk is able to take care of this nonsense. But anyway, Mayor Sullen escaping the custody and retaking Traveler's Landing? What is going on? Darkblade and a group of humans from Esten arrive in Illa at the request of Zovan and Atristan, on a mission to put an end to the Villager-Illager War. Ivan learns of Darkblade's presence in Illa after he kills a group of villager scouts. Yeah, I probably shouldn't have done that. Darkblade takes refuge in the Isla town of Pasiones Puerto in hopes of escaping Ivan's watch. Man, this thing seems to be eerily focused around me. That's kind of scary. Who's been watching me? Hopefully it's not Ivan. Skulton retakes the Skult, starting a civil war with Pumpig and the Palumbran Empire. Captain Dusk is exiled to the southeast tropics of Esten, while Skulton has the Skult warriors executed for disloyalty? Oh no. What has been going on in Esten since I left? This is not good. This is not good at all. Oh man, do I stay in Illa, or... Nah. Maybe I should trust Captain Dusk. I gave him the leadership role for a reason. I knew he could handle it, but seems like he might need some help. Hopefully he can handle it, because I'm pretty preoccupied with Illa. I need to get through this book and head over to Vinctum. But let's see what happens next. I'm kind of nervous. Ivan finally acquires knowledge and secures his Killager bunker? Wait a minute. Oh no. I should have destroyed it. General Vlad decimates the Isla town of Macello using an old decimator prototype. That's what that cannon was. Darkblade executes a pillager captain in South Viridi, learning of an impending attack on the nearby town of Vinctum. General Vlad then initiates the Battle of Vinctum against Darkblade and several human travelers. Wait, hold up, hold up. It said he initiated it. Is this book self-updating? Is the battle going on right now? Oh man, I need to get the heck out of here, I need to get to Vinctum.